and welcome to our program, A Catalyst of Peace and Tranquility in the Indian Ocean Region, protecting more than 8,000 kilometers of coastline and more than 2 million square kilometers of exclusive economic zone, and at the helm of more than 1 lakh dedicated and trained people. Please welcome the Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral D.K. Joshi. Welcome, sir. Thank you for coming. Just to give you a little context of the background of the audience, we have a very diverse group of young people with us here today. They're from different schools and colleges, institutes of mass communication, Institute of Film and Television, and of course from fashion technology and management. And they're eagerly looking forward to this interaction. We have the first question from this young lady.
Hello, sir. My name is Simran, and I'm half Kashmiri and half Punjabi. My question is that what is that thing that made you join the Naval Army and not any other army? What is that thing that inspired you to join this force?
Well, Simran, firstly, whilst you are half Kashmiri and half Punjabi, that is incidental. I am certain that you are a full Indian to begin with. Yeah. The question as to why I joined the Navy and why not the other two services, well, firstly, it was so many years ago that one seems to have really forgotten. But I think it was the lure of the seas, the pull of the unknown. Because we actually belong to Uttarakhand, which was the UP at that time, and to the hills really. So the landmass, the hilly terrains, one had seen enough. And it was to venture out into something that one had not experienced, that I think was the major pull.
Hello sir, I am Gunit. I am full Punjabi. Did your family support you in your decision to be a part of Indian Navy?
So, I hope you are also a full Indian.
Yes, I am
right.
Full Indian.
Okay. Yes, in the sense, of course, parents, firstly from both my father's side and my mother's side, for seven generations, either way, nobody has been into the services. And therefore, they had perhaps not even thought of armed forces as a career option. But once I had made up my mind, they were of course fully supportive.
What has been your most memorable experience in your service period till now?
It's a bit of a difficult question to answer because once you spent more than 40 years in uniform, it is a bit difficult to give, to prioritize one episode or one experience over some other. But that said, I would tend to put, I think, my command of the aircraft as at that slot, at that level. Because it's, even for those in the Navy, a service on an aircraft career is altogether a different ball game. It has also been said that an aircraft carrier is not a ship, it's a city, and its captain is not its captain, but the mayor. So, to command the carrier, the Virat, which I had the good fortune of, was all experience, I think, in that league. There are so many different things going on all over at any given point in time. When you have the air squadrons embarked, there are 16 or 1700 people under your command, different types of aircraft, different types of activities going on day and night, helicopter flying, fighter flying, interceptions, things of that nature. That excitement is something not there at all on different, on the other ships at all.
Whatever you have aimed in your life, have you achieved that?
When I joined, I had never for a moment thought that I'll one day become the chief. And the promotional structure in the armed forces is a steep pyramid. At the top there is only one, and at the base and in the lower ranks you need so many more. So it's a very it's a promotion system where every 12-13 years there are promotion boards, and gradually in the first board typically 50% make it, 50% don't make it, and as you grow up the ladder, it becomes even more stringent, and towards the final stages maybe 2 or 3 out of 10 make it. So I had never thought that I would rise to become the chief, and therefore it has way exceeded my expectations.
I'm Nidhi from Bhavan's Management Institute. Sir, you're managing an organization which is having around 60,000 people as workforce. So, sir, at times, how difficult and how easy to manage a workforce which is so diverse?
Well, Nidhi, firstly, in times of numbers, Navy really has more like 3 times the figure that you're talking about. Our officer strength alone is in the range of, I think, around 9,000. We have almost 90,000 sailors in uniform, and unknown to many, our civilian component is again extensive, because all our naval dockyards in Mumbai, in Vizag, in Karwar, Port Blair, Cochin, everywhere, they are staffed and manned principally by the civilian workers, as also our armament depots. So it is, the figure is roughly 3 times that, and managing such a large body of men, yes, certainly it has complex challenges. But in the armed forces, in particular Navy, again, we have a very structured, disciplined workforce.
As the students of management, what is a lesson we can learn from you?
The span of control is one of the terminologies that you use in your management institutes. It's very refined, and you are in very frequent touch with them. In fact, currently technology provides many enablers, and therefore not necessarily through phone calls or mobile and all that, on video talks. Virtually on a daily basis, you are in touch with all your outstations, with your senior commanders, and you keep a finger on the pulse of the manpower. But it certainly has many complexities, and it is not a simple task.
How does it feel when you are at such a position, at such a great responsible position of being an admiral?
Well, you have to, firstly, it's certainly not a burden, and there is a tremendous responsibility, because whilst we ourselves don't categorize where we are in order of world rankings, but if you go into the net, you will for the most part find us, the Indian Navy, listed as the 5th largest in the world, and therefore to command the 5th largest Navy in the world has a certain sense of elation. And of course, a very vast sense of responsibility.
सर, मेरा सवाल है कि आज हमारी कंट्री के करेंट सिनारियों में ढेर सारे स्कैम के मामले आ रहे हैं, देश में निराशा का माहौल हो गया है. ऐसे में कौन सी ऐसी बातें हैं जो कि आपको देश सेवा के लिए ऑनेस्ट बनाए रखती है, एक और एक युवा होने के नाते मुझे आप क्या संदेश देना चाहेंगे?
हाँ नीतीश, ये तो बहुत मैं मानता हूँ आपसे कि बहुत अनफॉर्चुनेट वो है कि तरह तरह के स्कैम की रिपोर्ट आती है. उसमें कितनी सच्चाई है, उसकी वास्तविकता क्या है, ये तो जब इन्वेस्टिगेशन और एग्जामिनेशन उसका हो जाए पूरी तरह से तभी पता चलता है. कई बार कई अलग अलग कारणों से भी कुछ इस तरह की चीज़ें जो हैं सामने लाई जाती हैं, लेकिन जो जितनी हैं उसमें जितनी सच्चाई है उसमें भी ये काफ़ी दुखद बात है. और मेरा मानना तो यही है कि देश के प्रति पूरा कमिटमेंट, अपने फेलो बीइंग्स के प्रति पूरी संवेदना, उन सेंसिटिविटी रहे उनकी. कोई किसी को अपने से, हर काम का अपना महत्व होता है, कोई बड़ा काम नहीं होता है, कोई छोटा काम नहीं होता है. जैसे हम शिप में कहते हैं कि कैप्टन से लेकर के जो सबसे जूनियर फंक्शनरी है, जो सबसे जूनियर फंक्शनरी है वो कैप्टन का काम नहीं कर सकता है, जो कैप्टन है वो जूनियर फंक्शनरी का काम नहीं कर सकता है, तो हर आदमी की जो है अहमियत को इम्पोर्टेंस दी जाए और देश के प्रति अपने अपने कर्तव्य को जो है वो कभी ना भूला जाए। तो अगर ये संदेश आप लोग पहले अगर समझ सकें और सारे राज्यों से आए हैं वापस जा कर के अपने साथ वालों को, अपने क्लास वालों को, स्कूलेज़ कॉलेजेस वगैरह में इसको प्रोपोगेट कर सकें, तो मेरे ख्याल से उससे बड़ा अचीवमेंट और इस फोरम का हो नहीं सकता है।
सर, एक सवाल हमारी तरफ से, युवा होने के नाते कहीं हर एक चीज़ में एक जल्दी होती है, पेशेंस थोड़ी मुश्किल से आती है, और सर्विसेज में ट्रेनिंग, डिसिप्लिन चीज़ का लंबा फ़ायदा देखना एक और चीज़ सिखाई जाती है, तो ये जो एनर्जी, जो ये एडवेंचर होती है, इस स्पिरिट को टेम करना इतने सारे लोगों में और डिसिप्लिन करके और फिर उसका नतीजा देखना, ये कैसे ट्रेनिंग दी जाती है?
भाई, आपने बड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग सवाल पूछा है। एस्पिरेशंस होते हैं, हर चीज़ किसी का, किसी के दिमाग में कोई आइडिया आता है, कोई प्रपोजल आता है, वो उसको उसी समय इम्प्लीमेंट होना देखना चाहता है। तो इसके दो तीन स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं जिससे बेसिक इसका आंसर मेरे हिसाब से रहता है एंगेजमेंट में। आप अपनी अपने कलीग्स से, अपने सबॉर्डिनेट्स से हर समय एंगेज्ड रहें, टू वे डायलॉग रहे। कोई आइडिया आया है, उधर इम्पेशेंस है कि उसको इम्प्लीमेंट किया जाए, प्रायमा फेसी जो है वो आइडिया जो है बेनिफिशियल लगता है, लेकिन उसको हर दृष्टिकोण से एग्जामिन किया जाता है। अगर वो पर्सनल रिलेटेड है या एचआर रिलेटेड है तो करियर पाथ पे उसके बड़े एडवांटेजेस दिखाई पड़ेंगे आपको, लेकिन जब आप उसका डिटेल्ड एग्जामिनेशन करेंगे, कई बार हो सकता है कि आपको लगे कि इम्प्लीमेंटेबल नहीं है, क्योंकि किसी शिप का या एयर स्क्वाड्रन का या एयरक्राफ्ट कैरियर का एक तरह का स्ट्रक्चर होता है, अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट्स होते हैं, अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट्स की अलग अलग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ होती हैं, काम होते हैं, उसके लिए एक तरह का स्ट्रक्चर चाहिए होता है। और ये जो इनोवेटिव आइडिया जो आया है, जो खाली पर्सनल एंगल से आया है, इसकी एप्लीकेबिलिटी यहाँ नहीं हो सकता है, नहीं हो, कई बार हो भी सकती है। तो अगर आप लोगों से एंगेज्ड रहें, टू वे डायलॉग ओपन रखें और उनको बताते रहें, तो इसका जो है मेरे ख्याल से एक बड़ा अच्छा बैलेंस जो है प्राप्त किया जा सकता है, जो होता है कई बार।
और कहीं ये यंग ऑफिसर की ट्रेनिंग होती है टू ग्रो सीनियर इन रैंक एंड टू बी एबल टू सी द बिगर पिक्चर, दिस हेल्प्स।
तो ट्रेनिंग का हमारे कॉन्टेक्स्ट में हमने ऐसा किया है कि उसको कई तरीके से कैटेगराइज किया है, और अगेन उसमें मैनेजमेंट में एक कॉन्सेप्ट है जस्ट इन टाइम। तो जो ट्रेनिंग हम इम्पार्ट करते हैं वो जस्ट इन टाइम फॉर द जॉब फॉर विच अ पर्सन इज गोइंग। सो एब इनिशियो ट्रेनिंग सबकी सेम होती है, कैडेट्स अकेडमी से आए, जूनियर लेवल्स पर ट्रेनिंग हुई, उसके बाद जो है वो इनिशियली जो है वॉच कीपिंग ऑफिसर्स बने, उसके बाद जब उनकी फर्दर ग्रोथ शुरू हुई फिर उनको जो है कंपार्टमेंटलाइज किया जाता है अलग अलग स्पेशलाइजेशंस में। कोई एविएटर बनना चाहता है, हवाई जहाज उड़ाना चाहता है, कोई सबमरीनर बनना चाहता है, पनडुब्बी में जाना चाहता है, कोई जनरल सर्विस में गनरी एंड मिसाइलरी एक्सपर्ट बनना चाहता है, कोई नेविगेशन एंड डायरेक्शन में जाना चाहता है, कोई मेरी तरह से एंटी सबमरीन वॉरफेयर में जाना चाहता है। तो उस लेवल पर आकर के उसको खाली वही ट्रेनिंग दी जाती है, फिर उसकी जैसी ग्रोथ होती गई फिर उसमें मिड करियर अपग्रेड्स होते हैं, स्टाफ कॉलेज होता है, हायर कमांड कोर्सेज होते हैं, फाइनली जो है जब वो वन स्टार लेवल के आसपास पहुंच जाता है, ब्रिगेडियर इक्विवेलेंट, कोमोडोर इक्विवेलेंट, नेशनल डिफेंस कॉलेज दिल्ली में है। तो एक समय की ट्रेनिंग मतलब किसी को ऐसी नहीं दी जाती कि वो हर चीज़ के लिए साथ के साथ क्वालिफाई हो गया है, उसकी प्रोग्रेस कैसी है, एप्टीट्यूड कैसा है, खुद क्या चाहता है, इन सब चीज़ों को ध्यान में रखते हुए उनको कंपार्टमेंटलाइज करते हैं। और मैं सोचता हूँ कि हालांकि किसी किसी को हो सकता है फाइनली जो है सेटिस्फेक्शन नहीं भी हो, लेकिन एट अ रफ अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेरे ख्याल से अपवर्ड्स ऑफ 90% दे आर सेटिस्फाइड विद द ट्रेनिंग दैट दे हैव बीन गिवन, दे आर सेटिस्फाइड विद द ब्रांचेज और स्पेशलाइजेशंस और सब स्पेशलाइजेशंस दैट दे हैव बीन अलोकेटेड, एंड इट्स बीन वर्किंग वेल फॉर अस।
Hello, sir. My name is Vidit. I come from the city of Dilwalo ki Delhi, and of course, I'm an Indian. My question is that what are the various perks and perquisites of a Navy job that other jobs do not have?
Armed forces in general and Navy is not really about perks and perquisites. So if it is only the perks and perquisites that you are looking for, then the answer may perhaps lie elsewhere. But that having been said, the Navy is an exciting career option. It offers decent money. It offers you a very comfortable living, not luxurious living. It offers you fullest of scope to realize your dreams and your potential. Apart from whatever the Navy as a service may require from you, it encourages your development in so many different ways. I don't know how many of you followed, just 4 days ago, President of India, and I had accompanied him in Bombay, welcomed the first ever Indian who has circumnavigated the globe solo, non-stop, unassisted. Abhilash Tomy. So that was his dream, that was his aspiration. What did the Navy do about it? We supported it to the fullest extent, bought for him the best ocean-going one-man yacht that the money can buy, gave him the best coaching that money can procure anywhere globally, gave him any number of rehearsal runs, shorter ones, you know, Mauritius to India, India to Mauritius, that way and back. So, insofar as adventure sports and endeavors of that nature is concerned, we support all these initiatives fully. Housing, wherever you see, I don't know if you go through the Kent area and all that, in wherever we are, excellent housing in perhaps the best part of any given city, etc., etc. Good medical facilities, good Medicare, good travel facilities, a very sort of sheltered way of life, in the sense you are not exposed to so many harsh day-to-day realities outside because your own structures cater for all of them. So these are what you could count equivalent to perks and privileges, but we don't look at perks and privileges. We look because we want to serve. And therefore, it's an exciting career option, and I would encourage as many of you who are inclined that way to make Navy your career option.
How does the Navy encourage them to become the right people? एक सवाल
सर, आप कॉन्फ्रेंस आउट होते हैं तो उसमें जो रिजल्ट बनता है हमको शो नहीं किया जाता, हम कॉन्फ्रेंस आउट हो जाते हैं, हमको पता नहीं चल पाता हमारी वीकनेस क्या है.
जो सर्विसेज सेलेक्शन बोर्ड्स हैं उसका जो है उसमें दो कंपार्टमेंट्स होते हैं.
यस सर.
एक जो है साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्ट कहते हैं, दूसरा जो है रेंज ऑफ एक्टिविटीज होती है जिसमें ग्रुप टास्क, डिबेट्स, ऑब्स्टेकल कोर्सेज, उस तरह की लीडरशिप क्वालिटीज, उस तरह के जो है असेसमेंट होते हैं. इसमें जो साइकोलॉजिकल वाला है वो एक स्पेशलाइज्ड एजेंसी है डीआरडीओ की, डिफेंस रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट की एक एजेंसी है, डीआईपीआर, डिफेंस इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइकोलॉजिकल रिसर्च. सो उसके टेस्ट जो है वो डिज़ाइन करते हैं और वही उनको एग्जामिन करते हैं. अब उसमें क्या स्ट्रक्चर है जिससे कि वो और उनके पास 60 साल का एक्सपीरियंस है और ये प्रोसेस वो साल ब साल रिफाइन करते रहते हैं, लेकिन वो क्या इंडिकेटर्स हैं जिसके बतौर वो डिटरमिन करते हैं कि भाई ऑफिसर लाइक क्वालिटीज़ हैं नहीं हैं या साइकोलॉजिकली सूटेड है नहीं है, वो इतनी कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस है कि वो पहले तो किसी को बताते नहीं हैं. और दूसरा एक्सपीरियंस से ये देखा गया है कि SSB के मेरे जहाँ तक मुझे याद है 3 अटेम्प्ट्स अलाउड होते हैं, 3 हैं, तो मान लो कोई एक बार नहीं निकला, कई लोग सेकंड में निकल जाते हैं, कुछ लोग थर्ड में भी निकल जाते हैं, लेकिन जहाँ तक मुझे पता है साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्ट में जो पहली बार फेल हुआ है वो कभी निकला नहीं है, बाकी चीज़ों में वो लोग इम्प्रूव करके निकल जाते हैं. तो वो इसलिए मैं मानता हूँ कि वो बहुत ही वर्टिकली स्पेशलाइज्ड प्रोसेस है उनकी DIPR की, ये डिटरमिन करने के लिए कि भाई इस आदमी में वो जो चीज़ें हम देख रहे हैं वो हैं या नहीं है, और वो चीज़ें ऐसी नहीं हैं जो ट्रेनिंग से या कोचिंग क्लासेस करने से आ जाएंगी। सजेशन जो मैं आपको यही दे सकता हूँ कि कुछ प्रेपरेटरी अकेडमीज़ वगैरह हैं वहाँ, वहाँ जो है इस तरह के एंडेवर्स होते हैं, लेकिन वो साइकोलॉजिकल जो आस्पेक्ट है वो तो या तो किसी में है या नहीं है। उसको जो है, जहाँ तक मेरा अनुभव है, उसको कोचिंग करके या प्रैक्टिस करके या सेकंड वाली बार में या थर्ड वाली बार में आके वो नहीं आएगा, वो आप में है या नहीं है। लेकिन बहुत कम लोग होते हैं जो मतलब इस श्रेणी में आते हैं, मेजॉरिटी जो है रिजल्ट्स सक्सेसफुल होते हैं लोग।
एक सवाल है सर, जो ऐसी चीज़ है जो हमें कुछ करने नहीं देती, उसके बारे में।
हेलो सर, मेरा नाम हेमंत है, मैं उत्तराखंड से हूँ। बीइंग द नेवी चीफ, मुझे पता है कि नेवी जो है इट्स अ सिंबल ऑफ पावर, परसेवेरेंस, इंटेग्रिटी और फियरलेसनेस। तो मेरे इनफैक्ट आई हैव टू क्वेश्चंस। फर्स्ट इज, बीइंग द नेवी चीफ, डू यू फेयर एनीथिंग इन लाइफ? एंड द सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज, हम अपनी लाइफ से फियर को कैसे हटा सकते हैं?
ऑफ व्हाट इज नोन, आई रियली डोंट फेयर एनीथिंग। वन हैज टू हैव कंसर्न्स, वन हैज टू एनालाइज दोज कंसर्न्स, एंड वन हैज टू डेवलप काउंटर्स, but no purpose would be served by admitting defeat and saying that I am in fear of x y z. So that is what my recommendation to would be, that you categorize your apprehensions, categorize your concerns, and develop strategies to counter them. In not all of them will you be able to develop strategies that counter them 100%, but in so far as you've been able to develop those that are able to counter 70% or 80%, I think you have to that extent put your mind at rest.
So you talk of fearing the unknown, and you live in the ocean. The ocean is unknown. How do you conquer that?
Now the ocean is known. Within that, yes, there are contingencies that develop there that cannot always be forecast or predicted, and therefore you have to sort of see, anticipation, I think I put a great value on anticipation, that you think and at all points in time anticipate that what could be happening, what could be going wrong. In particular, I recall when I was on commanding the carrier, flying operations are going on, aircraft are taking off. I used to encourage my officers and those on watch that whatever is happening, all right, but all the time your mind should be ticking. To think up of contingencies, should something go wrong, what are you going to be doing? There are standard operating procedures. So aircraft accident, it can happen. I mean, the aircraft is not going to announce that there is going to be an engine failure. True. And I have had experiences of that nature. So all the time you need to be anticipating what is going to be happening ahead, and out of that, what is it that could be going wrong, and how will you tackle and deal with that?
So in your experience, when the aircraft engine failed and you were in the aircraft?
No, I was not. I was in the carrier.
Okay. And then how did you feel? Because your men were there.
Yes, I had a pilot there, and it happened during recovery of one of our fighter aircraft, and it plonked on deck and turned turtle. And but the team was swift, and obviously they had been anticipating that should a contingency of this nature come up at any time, this will be our counter.
और सर, मेरा क्वेश्चन आपसे ये है कि हर किसी का एक सपना होता है बचपन से कुछ बनने का, तो आप बचपन से ही नेवी में आना चाहते थे, आपकी ड्रीम थी या डेस्टिनी आपको यहाँ ले आई?
एडुकेशन के हिसाब से मैंने स्कूल लीविंग तक पीसीएम किया था, फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री मैथमेटिक्स। उसके बाद जो है मैंने, जैसे अभी रेफर किया था, स्विच ओवर कर दिया था हिस्ट्री ऑनर्स को ब्रीफ उसके लिए, लेकिन मेरे ख्याल से स्कूल छोड़ने की स्टेज के आसपास से मेरे मन में चाम आ गया था कि नेवी में जाने का है। तो ये बाकी सब ये एक्सपेरिमेंटल जो है ट्रांजिशन, हिस्ट्री ऑनर्स वगैरह, वैसे उसमें कोई मेरा खास दिल नहीं था, और इसीलिए विद इन 6 months आई हैड लेफ्ट एंड गॉन।
सर, अगर आप नेवी में नहीं होते तो क्या होते?
शायद डॉक्टर होता। हालांकि अगर मैं देखूँ तो पीसीएम था, वो डॉक्टर की तरफ लीड नहीं कर रहा था। उसके बाद हिस्ट्री ऑनर्स किया, वो भी डॉक्टर की तरफ लीड नहीं कर रहा था। लेकिन पता नहीं कहाँ से मेरे बैक ऑफ माय माइंड है कि शायद मैं डॉक्टर होता कैसे पता नहीं।
आपकी लाइफ में एक बहुत स्पेशल रिश्ता है पानी के साथ, उस रिश्ते के बारे में ये यंग लेडी वांट्स टू आस्क यू।
हाउ कैन यू स्टे फॉर सो लॉन्ग इन वाटर than on land.
Being in the Navy does not mean that you are really living on water for extended durations. In the Navy in particular, and there are differences between the Indian Navy and the mercantile marine, or what is called the merchant navy. Now, merchant navy, you spend, I think, considerable time at sea, because your whole task is conveying cargo from point A to point B, dislodge cargo, take cargo again, come back. So you sail a lot. In the Navy, in the Indian Navy, there are finite durations that you go out on a ship or a submarine or on an aircraft carrier to sea for a finite purpose, a series of exercises. Moment that gets accomplished, you come back to shore, and then you do your shore workups, your tactical trainers, your at times your ship or the submarine requires refit, maintenance, repairs, things like that. So it isn't that you are at sea all the time. On a given average, you would be spending considerable time in harbor, maybe half a month in harbor.
How you give your time to your family?
For those who are posted on ships, whether ships or submarines are sea going, it is a challenge. Because quite obviously, you are not able to devote as much time as you would like to the family.
आम तौर से जब बच्चे यूनिफॉर्म को देखते हैं तो नेवल यूनिफॉर्म उन्हें बहुत फैसिनेट करती है क्या कभी ऐसा भी होता है कि एक यंग रिक्रूट जब आपके पास आता है तो वो रियलाइज करता है कि पानी से उसे बहुत डर लगता है और वो वापस जाना चाहता है कि मैं सी पे रहने के लिए बना ही नहीं हूँ
अक्सर तो नहीं लेकिन कभी कभी ये होता है कि कोई आता है कई बार तो कई सारे लोग आते हैं जिनको स्विमिंग नहीं आती है और वो अपने बेसिक स्विमिंग टेस्ट्स जो है नहीं पास कर पाते हैं या स्विमिंग टेस्ट वगैरह पास कर भी लिया शिप में गए या सबमरीन में गए फेमिलराइजेशन सॉर्टीज के लिए और उनको एक तरह का फोबिया सा आ जाता है तो इस तरह के केसेस काफ़ी आइसोलेटेड हैं लेकिन होते हैं तो हमारा एफर्ट ये रहता है कि इनिशियल वो काउंसिलिंग मतलब कि वो खाली तो डर नहीं लग रहा है करके लेकिन जैसे ही ये आभास होता है कि इसको डर है हम कोई उसको फोर्स नहीं करते उसको एनकरेज करते हैं कि दूसरा करियर ऑप्शन ले ले और उसका एग्जिट जो है फैसिलिटेट करते हैं
हेलो सर मायसेल्फ हितेशी मल्होत्रा आई वांटेड टू आस्क व्हाट आर द करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर द मैनेजमेंट ग्रेजुएट्स इन द इंडियन नेवी
इन द नेवी ऑल ऑफ अस लाइक टू थिंक ऑफ आवरसेल्व्स एज मैनेजर्स सो एवरीबॉडी इज अ मैनेजर एंड ही इज अ मैनेजर इन अ डिफरेंट वे इवन अ यंग ऑफिसर विद जस्ट अबाउट 5 or 6 ईयर्स ऑफ सर्विस who has done, let's say, a specialization, for example, in gunnery and missilery, is the gunnery officer of a ship. He is managing the gunnery department of that ship. Its total combat power, the entire manpower that the gunnery department has, the guns, the missile batteries. So everyone in that sense is managing something or the other. And therefore, in the Navy, we don't have a management cadre at all, separate by itself. But graduates or you know people with management degrees would qualify for so many things. There are many I am aware of who are into our IT field. There are many who are into our logistics field. So avenues there are aplenty.
So this young man has a torpedo question.
Hello, sir. The first thing I would like to say is it's a beautiful opportunity today to sit here in front of you. What I have is really not a question, but it's a thought that came in my head. Sir, you guys are like the pioneers of honesty. So why don't you join politics? I know it's not a very inviting career, but it's going to change the face of it.
So if you yourself say it's not a inviting career, then I don't think it's a fair question to ask. But there again, it is left to individuals. And I think there have been very isolated cases, but I can offhand think of at least one central minister and one chief minister of a state who were ex-armed forces. Okay. But that is only one example, you know, in the midst of so many millions of people who have served at one point of time or the other. That's a challenge of a different nature. And I think by the time most of our people exit, they are in the 60s. They have missed out what is required at the grassroots level, and majority of careers require some experience at grassroots level. Then you cannot suddenly transplant yourself at, you know. So I think it would be considerations of that nature.
My name is Addis Zakaria. So my question to you is, how do you compare Indian Marcos with respect to the US Navy SEALs?
Favorably.
That is, Indian Marcos is much better than US Navy SEALs.
Sare jahan se acha Hindustan mein. No, no, indeed. I mean, somebody may take it as having been said flippantly, but we train with the US Navy SEALs, with many other special forces, and in quite a few cases, our people have gone and topped the courses. They are highly committed, highly dedicated. But special forces or MACOs, as you mentioned, is a capacity that you don't too much talk about and discuss.
Keeping apart your Navy experiences, how emotionally attached are you to your uniform? And an extension of that is, do you fear the day when you'll have to keep your uniform in your cupboard and not wear it again?
So the uniform question you asked from the NIFT angle.
Kind of.
We love our uniforms and the Naval uniforms have been derived from the Royal Navy, which where the traditions go back a couple of centuries really, and we take great pride in our uniform. And majority of us, after retiring or after hanging up the uniform, have a set of each, and on special occasions wear them. Well, you can't wear all of this, but your miniature medals on ceremonial occasions, if you are invited, for example, to a Raj Bhavan for the Republic Day function or the Independence Day function, people very proudly display their series of miniature medals and their name tally and all that. And that is where majority of us have spent our entire lives. So you can't sort of, ditch it altogether.
There's also a well-known saying, so it says, you can take a man out of the uniform, but you can't take the uniform out of it.
Absolutely.
Hello sir, I'm Rajni. I'm student of mass media. And I want to know that can a media person join the Navy?
Whether you can join the Navy purely as a media person, well, we have a very small but dedicated PR cadre, public relations cadre, which would lend itself to a mass comm kind of a qualification.
What are the options for women in the Navy?
Women are currently being inducted into the aviation arm. They are observers. In fact, several batches are already inducted and passed out. They are into the education branch, logistic branch, law, ATC, and on the engineering side, naval constructors or naval architects. So there are many, many options that are open.
Hello, sir. My name is Akshat, and my question to you is, sir, like in today's time, even the war is televised live on television, and every decision that you make, it's hugely debated. So how do you cope up with the pressure?
Technology is the enabler which has made all of it possible, and therefore it brings a great complexity to your tasks, and your challenges are increased manifold. But then it does provide transparency, which requires additional effort, but it is for the larger good. And therefore has to be done.
Sir, as you are a specialist in anti-submarine warfare, the increasing number of Chinese submarines in Indian Ocean, are these a threat to Indian integrity?
Currently, there is no war on between any two given countries, and therefore, there is no nobody is posing anyone a threat. But concern, yes, certainly. So, all these developments need to be studied very, very attentively, your databases formatted, your strategies developed, and your thought process has to remain very, very focused in, should it become a threat at a point in time, how are we going to be dealing with it?
So, this program also has a strategy. My focus is also very clear. Right now, I need to take a break. Stay with us.
जब भी महात्मा गांधी, स्वामी विवेकानंद और कबीर जैसी महान हस्तियों का नाम लिया जाता है, जिन्हें सारी दुनिया इंसानियत की मिसाल मानती है, तब मुझे बड़ा गर्व महसूस होता है कि मैं भी उसी धरती से जन्मा हूँ, मैं भी उसी देश का वासी हूँ। भारत मेरी पहचान।
Welcome back in conversation with Young India, India's Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral D.K. Joshi. Admiral Joshi, a little shift, bringing out some lighter moments, a question.
Hello, my name is Priya Singh and I am from Allahabad, the holy city. And I would like to ask you a question that when you are on ship, then what is the source of your entertainment?
These days, the TV that you have in your place, with all the channels that are available there through satellite.
Which is your favorite movie?
I like all action thrillers. And I don't have a favorite. I have a favorite of the moment. And favorite of this moment is Skyfall.
So, other than that, Hindi movies, do they occupy some place?
Hindi movies, in the movie, and there are so many wannabe anchors here, there may be so many wannabe maybe media people. So, I seem to think that the best Hindi movies were made in the 60s, 50s, perhaps in the 70s. So, short answer is old classics.
Some old classic gana, which is a favorite?
All the songs of Guide. Such lovely songs.
Ah, that is quick. तो एक गाना गुनगुनाए गाइड का
आज फिर जीने की तमन्ना है
लवली
आज फिर जीने की तमन्ना है आज फिर मरने का इरादा है
आज फिर जीने की तमन्ना है आज फिर मरने का इरादा है आज फिर जीने की तमन्ना है आज फिर मरने का इरादा है
सर मैं आपसे पूछना चाहता हूं मैंने सुना है कि यूनिफॉर्म्स वालों पर लड़कियां मरती हैं क्या ये बात सही है
तो इसका जो है आंसर जानने का सबसे बढ़िया तरीका है कि आप यूनिफॉर्म पहन लें व्हाइट यूनिफॉर्म
ये जानना चाहता हूँ कि आप पर अभी तक कितनी लड़कियां मर चुकी हैं
नहीं नहीं और नहीं मैं अपना जो है वो आंसर कंटिन्यू कर रहा था अगर मर गई फिर फायदा क्या हो गया वो तो आपको यूनिफॉर्म में देख करके उनका मन आपके साथ जीने के लिए करना चाहिए
सर ऑल आवर सोर्सेज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट नेवी एंड आर्मी आर मूवीज war movies basically that we see. So, what do you think? How close is it to reality? And how do you feel while watching it, if you ever do?
See, the majority of movies that have been made have had a theme based on actuals. But the entire craft of movie making, I think, is, you know, you have to lend it to dramatization and all that. So, certain aspects of that nature come in. But the hardships that are shown, the challenges that emerge, they are real. And I would say that they are very, very realistic. There used to be a very old movie called Hakikat. I don't know whether anybody has seen it here or not. That movie had some of the best songs that I can remember. That was one. Hoke Majboor Mujhe, Usne Bhulaya Hoga. That was another one.
उसने भुलाया होगा, होके मजबूर मुझे उसने भुलाया होगा। जहर चुपके से दवा जान के खाया होगा, होके मजबूर मुझे उसने भुलाया होगा, होके मजबूर मुझे।
What's the one important thing that you want to still, like, you still want to do in your life, and what kind of a major change that you want to, you know, bring in the Navy, I mean in your tenure?
One major change that I want to do, which I know I cannot do, is to command an aircraft carrier again. I am too old. In the Navy, we sort of tend to look at it as incremental improvements rather than revolutionary changes. No, nobody is there with that great wisdom that he'll come perhaps as the chief and say everything before me. Before me was all deluge and I'm here to set it right. All of us during say last 10 years or thereabouts have been part of the top management and therefore are responsible fully for things as they exist, good, bad, ugly, whichever way they are. So therefore there is no need to change, you know, that one thing. Incremental improvements, newer technology comes in every day, newer platforms come in every day, their operating techniques are different, the maintenance philosophy is different. If you are following the media, you would be aware that we are now operating a nuclear submarine, one of the very few countries. We are a country that is constructing indigenously in India our own nuclear submarine. So all of them, require incremental changes to as existing processes and procedures. So that is what this is all about, rather than, you know, I will change that one thing, etc.
We have only one aircraft carrier, right? And geographically, half of the Indian land is covered by ocean on the map. So don't you think that we should have more aircraft carrier as Sea Harriers that we talk about? And how then with one aircraft carrier, how will counter China in this peninsula?
I entirely agree with you. One is totally inadequate and therefore we are procuring one, as you see in the media, from Russia to be named Vikramaditya. We are constructing one ourselves, one of the very few countries in the world to construct their own aircraft carriers in Cochin shipyard, and it should be ready to join the fleet in about 4 to 5 years time from now. It is, if you are in Cochin sometime, you can actually see it in the channel. So we aim to have at least two operational carrier groups available in the foreseeable future, and therefore to have two operational groups, you have to have one in refit and repair, so around three in the near to medium.
Uniform. I personally want to know that what this man actually is. You have a family. How do you guide your family? What are your likes? How do you guide them?
The current educational avenues are such that you are really not in a best position to advise them, nor should you actually want to do that. They are their own best advisors along with their peer group, and they are aware of what the current opportunities are, what are the various fields opening up. Somebody here earlier made a mention of MASCOM. My elder daughter is a MASCOM person. I didn't know what it meant actually. So then I figured out that it actually can lead into so many diverse fields.
Army is a place where you face death in reality. So what goes through a man's mind when he faces a death reality? I mean, is there any situation or what makes him a strong person to face reality?
This is a challenging job. There is that inherent risk involved. Somebody has to take that risk for the larger good, for the cause of the nation, etc. And many of us are driven, many don't seem to believe in it, but many of us are actually driven to take up that challenge.
Sir, how did you feel when you first, for the first time, entered a submarine? What did you feel? What kind of experience did you have?
So you have to actually volunteer to be a submariner. And there again, there was another question. There is an extensive and a very exhaustive psychological test that you have to pass to become a submariner. So not everyone is a submariner. I am not a submariner. But I have entered submarines. In fact, I have sailed on them in, you know, higher positions as commander-in-chief and all that. It's one of the most challenging assignments that anybody can take on. The working spaces are claustrophobic. It requires nerves of steel and determination of an exceptional order to volunteer for to become a submariner. And there are certain compensations, there are some extra pays and allowances and all that. But I am certain that these extra pays and allowances don't drive people who want to become submariners the world over. They are a breed unto themselves, steely characters, full of resolve, working under immense hardships to deliver the mandate.
Now we're going to do a little role reversal. Jinke paas sawal hai, aap haath khade karein aur sir will choose the person.
So you haven't asked a question yet. Third row, second from right.
आप अपने retirement के बाद क्या join करना चाहेंगे?
मैं अपने retirement के बाद retirement join करना चाहूँगा.
Just take two more questions. You have a choice again of the pick.
She sang that guide song beautifully. She gets two questions.
I want to ask you about your free time hobbies.
Essentially, whenever off and on I find time, I am an ardent deep sea game fisher. I don't know how many of you understand that. It's not really rods and reels. Well, it is also rods and reels, but blue marlin, wahoo. It's a highly specialized form of fishing, deep at sea, from boats where the fishing rod is actually embedded and the boat is actually moving, etc. So you can Google it. It takes a lot of time. It takes 6-8 hours per outing. Riding, that I do here, not often enough from my point of view of interest, but I ride in the ridge area next to the president's bodyguard grounds. Sometimes golf, snorkeling, scuba diving.
My second question is ke aap apni personal aur professional life ko kaise manage karte hain ek saath?
See, is stage par aakar ke kai sari cheeze hain, jaise mera seagoing career nahi hai, main ship mein nahi hun, command wagera nahi kar raha hun. So essentially ye jo hai headquarter wala function hai, to chahe bhale hi meetings ya conferences ya jo ho, sham ko to late se late kabhi ghar ko hi aate hain. So it is quite similar to, you know, pretty much everyone else. There are occasional tours, of course. There are durations that I go and embark on ships, submarines and aircraft, etc. But other than that, it is a fairly, at this level, it's a fairly structured living. She has not asked a question.
So who is your favorite actress in Bollywood?
Aishwarya Rai did some good movies, but in your terminology, she may not be current, no?
Well, thank you so much, Admiral Joshi, for we're home with this program. And though we'd love to carry on, you know, this conversation of learning and growing together.
Thank you, firstly, to Doordarshan, to Mr. Bakshi, who conceptualized this whole thing, to you, Gaurav, and to the youth from so many distant parts of our country, all of them Indians, for having spent this time with me and for having made me feel young, a part of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Delight.
Absolutely. Basically, it was getting to know the man behind the badge and to really know where the priorities lie for you as a person in life.
I guess this whole build-up about how it's something very serious and the people, you know, something that's not really accessible to normal people or common people, that whole perception sort of changed, you know. He is just like one of us, and he had his dreams and he went and sort of pursued them.
I realized that, you know, he's the man behind the uniform is, he's like a really nice guy. And it was a really important reminder for me that, you know, even nice guys can reach the top.
It's been a proud day. We have to got to meet Admiral, of course. He's a very big man, and still from his face we can judge that he's on rather than being on such a high position, he's still down to earth.
It has been an interesting day for me. I'd learned a lot and I've seen a lot, and I've learned that Admiral Joshi is a very interesting person.
बहुत अच्छा लगा यहाँ आके से कभी seriously.
It was great privilege to be here.
We enjoyed the program. It was very nice meeting with the Admiral D.K. Joshi, and we got a new experience meeting with such a big personality.
To be precise, we enjoyed a lot and we had a lot of fun.
We are very fortunate indeed to have this pleasure of, you know, meeting each such big people and having the time to interact with them.
It was actually amazing. Getting to know the person from inside, what it is like to be in the Navy, what are the career prospects, it was really great.
Well, seriously, if I hadn't come, I would have regretted not being here, because though the experience would have been formal, but it was really very informal.
The program was very nice, we got to learn a lot.
I'm very, very thankful to Doordarshan, who gave this opportunity
to us.
And thanks to all the team who has been working and who worked for this program and gave opportunity to us.